should not make a change, nothing strange. People, people, we are the same. No, we're not the same, cause we don't know the game. What we need is awareness, we can't get careless. You say, what is this? Yeah. Papa love it, let's get down to business. Mental self-defense or fitness.
Don't rush the show. You got to go for what you know.
We got to fight the power that beats.
Hello, and I am a visual artist, and you're listening to Art Park Hill, and I am also a visual artist, and you're listening to Street Artist here in Charlotte.
So, it was probably the, I don't know what they call it, of hope. There was one out of Charlotte, I moved here 10 years ago from Atlanta, and it's different. So being part of this, I felt like for the first time, I was part of that voice that I came here to seek, and I'm incredibly honored to be here. Such incredible minds around me, and that it was Black Red, that was probably one of the strongest statements that we could do for our city.
It was really amazing to see over the past, like, 6 years, 7 years that we've been painting and working, just this movement of the artists. And like the power that they've been able to generate, especially out here. I know Dan Wesley's got this area pretty much. He can pull parties together. He knows everybody in his community. He brings everyone together. Same with Bigger Arts out this up the way. Kind of the same thing. But it was really neat seeing the power of him just putting out the call to several people and then putting out the call to more people and just the amount of people that were not only just out there painting and designing the letters, but assisting, helping, everybody wanting to be part of this thing. It was incredible. It was really, really, inspiring.
So we were giving the letter L, if possible, that we have to unite together to speak up, to stand up for each other, to vote. So I'm talking to all my Latinos to please vote. Please go out there. We need more bodies and more voices heard.
I'm not Colombian, I am white and Colombian, I'm mixed. So I reap the benefits, obviously, of looking very white. I grew up very white. Didn't really look at my culture or anything until we met. And listening to the stories of when she came to the U.S. and how the school system treated her, how the community treated her, and kids like her. I mean, it made me cry in parts hearing some of these things. And since then, I can't help but want to be beside her, helping push anything that she has, because she thinks first and foremost about her community, about others, even after being treated the way she was. And so seeing that power and learning that, with our Latinos and the Black community getting together, the struggle is similar, like the discrimination is similar, and there's, like she said, there's no way you can expect any kind of rights or respect for immigrant populations if you can't even respect a population that's been here since the beginning of this country. And so it means a lot to be here with her and to be able to be called a teammate to help with this.
I think what I was waiting for a long time was for Charlotte to give creatives, people of color, a space to elevate ourselves, a space to celebrate ourselves. And I think in a few days, we show Charlotte that it's possible, that it only takes for more people to come out and look at the diversity of artists that we have in Charlotte. So this is just step one. We'll continue to add uplift. We're personally making changes so that our earnings are not just for ourselves. We always think about collectives and how they impact us. And while we're gaining a platform, we're also thinking about everyone around us. So we hope to continue to use our platform to uplift people of color, and we continue to encourage any business out there to reach out to more of these collectives that are uplifting the diversity and amazing talent that y'all have to show. So I think we've set a voice for the art community, that we're united, that we have a big voice, that we're putting more money into our pockets so that we can create actual change. So to me, I see hope in our art community. I need it.
I see everything that's happened up to now has started and giving people the chance to have these hard conversations and talk to people about having these hard conversations that are uncomfortable means that you're working through stuff and you grow. I've had them with friends and family lately, and it's, while it's hard, it's necessary to the point that people out there are like, I never really understood what was going on. And now I'm like, it's not about us not being racist or saying you're not racist or not discriminating or protecting yourself, but it's about being actively anti-racist.
Seeing older generations start saying things like that and thinking of things that way gives me a lot of hope for the future. Because they're seeing that they can change, and they're seeing that the same things that a lot of them were fighting for then, we're still pushing that football kind of forward. But we're able to do it a lot faster now, and a lot more effectively, a lot more collectively. Which touches back to seeing everything that we've done up to now, we can only expect to see bigger and better. We're really excited to be part of anything that anyone has, you know, put out there. It's not really for us, but it's for everybody, and that's why we do what we do.
I really want everyone to reach out to Black Market, come to these events. This is my neighborhood. I live across the street, so please come by and you probably see everyone's work and you'll see some of mine, but I'd rather you see their work first.
Instagram, blackmarket.clp. Same thing, I definitely want to shout out Black Market and Wesley for doing this. Sorry, Tiger's been pushing a lot of these things too, so I'm so sorry. Brandon Ma for putting that part of my company with that project together, you know, but that's really it. Look at for myself, my spray is usually free, so look around the drive field. But yeah, anything that you want to do to support us, please put that forward towards coming out here and supporting any kind of business of color, any kind of person that's out there trying to make a difference on their own. Give them some support when you can do it financially or, you know, just giving out that call, having gifts, giving them doors, helping to get away for free. Help the community, and that's really the thing that they are. That'll be things in our friends' way.